Good morning, welcome to a new session of video class. In this class, I will discuss about two important topics. One is the weightlessness and the second one is the physiological effects of astronauts. The two topics, the weightlessness and the physiological effects of astronauts, both are totally related to the astronauts. It means that the persons who will go to the space. These are very interesting, very important general topics that everybody should know about the contents of these two topics. And of course, these two topics are also cover the syllabus of the first semester of the BSc students. Whatever it might be, I said that these two are very interesting general topics, and this is okay, certainly adds knowledge regarding to the weightlessness and the physiological effects of the astronauts. Okay, right, let us move to the first topic, that is weightlessness. Weightlessness, it means that it is the loss of weight of a body or the loss of weight of human being. Loss of weight means actually, is it the real effect? No, it is not the real effect. It is a feeling of weightlessness. Astronauts feel that they lose their weight. They feel that they are weightlessness. Therefore, our interest as far as this topic is concerned, what is weightlessness? How it arises, what are the actual cause for the weightlessness, or what is the actual mechanism that leads to the feeling of the weightlessness, and what are the effects of the weightlessness, are the important contents that we have to learn from this topic. My focus is mainly on what is the reason for weightlessness, what is the cause for weightlessness, which physical phenomena leads to the feeling of the weightlessness is my interest. Right, we will see all these things one by one, okay, while we are discussing about this topic. First of all, weightlessness is the complete or near complete absence of the sensation of the weight. Okay, it is the sensation of loss of weight. It is not true. It is only the sensation of loss of weight, or what is, only it is the feeling of loss of weight. This is also termed as zero G. And more correctly, it is termed as zero G force. It means that zero gravitational force is nothing but the weightlessness. It means that the gravitational force is said to be zero, or if it is zero due to some conditions, then we will feel the sensation of weightlessness. Right. Now, what is the most important part of this one? Why we feel weightlessness? What is the cause for the weightlessness? Okay, right. The actual reason is It occurs in the absence of any contact forces upon objects or bodies, including the human body. What is this one? The feeling of weightlessness or the sensation of weightlessness is arised because of the absence of any contact forces upon objects or upon bodies and also upon human body. It means that the absence of contact force is the actual cause for the feeling of the sensation of the weightlessness. Right. We will see how it arises. Weightlessness is a condition experienced in the state of free fall. Actually, the weightlessness is the condition that experienced in the state of free fall, in which the effect of gravity is cancelled by the inertial force, that is the centrifugal force, resulting from the orbital flight. It means that in case of orbital flight, or in case of astronauts that are moving around the earth in a particular orbit, in their spaceship, that is what is called a satellite, what will be happening is the gravitational force is cancelled by the centrifugal force. As the gravitational force is cancelled by the centrifugal force, the spaceship or the satellite and the crew and the persons that are there in the spaceship are said to be in the state of free fall. Therefore, when once they are in the state of free fall, then this feeling of weightlessness is arised. The term zero gravity is often used to describe such a condition. Zero gravity, in order to describe this condition, we will make use of the term zero gravity. Weightlessness is nothing but the zero gravity condition. Astronauts who are orbiting the Earth often experiences the sensation of the weightlessness. Actually, the feeling of weightlessness is related to or connected to the astronauts. The members that are presented in the satellite, which is rotating around the Earth in a particular orbit, experience this sensation of the weightlessness. Of course, the same sensation is slightly experienced by anyone who was seated in a giant wheel while the wheel is rotating down. Just for your convenience, I will give some example, that is the rotation of giant wheel. The giant wheel rotates in a vertical circle. During the descending of circle of rotation, it means that when the giant wheel is coming down from your position, during that period we feel slightly the weightlessness, slightly the loss of weight. It means that we will feel that we are supposed to just float in the air, and because of this floating effect, because of this slight loss of weightlessness, we will feel a kind of inconvenience while the giant wheel is making its descending rotation with our presence in that particular period. It is a slight loss of weight. It is also due to what is on the feeling of the weightlessness. Therefore, the feeling of weightlessness is such, can also be felt in certain some other cases also, not completely, but a slight variation. But as far as the astronauts is concerned, they feel totally the weightlessness. And in the beginning itself, I said that it is due to the lack of contact forces. Right, now we will see, what are contact forces, how the lack of contact forces leads to the weightlessness. We will see all these things now onwards. Right. There are two category of forces. One is the contact forces and the other one is the non-contact forces. Non-contact forces are also known as the action at a distance force. Contact forces means the forces that are arrived when two bodies are in contact, in physical contact. When the two bodies are in physical contact, the force that arises between their contact is known as the contact forces. Non-contact forces are action at a distance forces. So means that if there is a force between two bodies without contact, certainly there are so many forces that will act in the universe in between any two bodies without their physical contact. Therefore, without physical contact also there are so many forces. Such forces are known as the action at a distance forces or non-contact forces. Or on the other hand, so there are contact forces which arises because of the physical contact of the two bodies. Right. When we sit when you sit in a chair, you will experience two forces. When we sit in a chair, we will be applied by two forces. One is the force of Earth's gravitational field pulling you down towards the Earth, and the other force is the chair pushing you upwards. And once we sit, or when once a person sat on a chair, he will be acted by two forces. One is the gravitational force pulls him towards the center of the Earth. The other one is the force applied by the chair in the vertical upward direction. The chair pushing you in the upward direction. The upward chair force is sometimes referred as the normal force, and it is due to the contact between the chair top and your bottom end. Okay, the force that arises or that acts between the two bodies in contact, or here in this case the chair top and your bottom, is known as normal force. It arises because of the contact between the chair and the bottom of the person. This is due to the friction between the two surfaces in contact, and this force is a normal force because it is acting vertically upwards to the surfaces in contact. That's why it is known as the normal force. This normal force is categorized as contact force, or this normal force is nothing but the contact force because it is arising because of the physical contact between the two bodies, which acts in a direction vertically upwards to the surface in contact. Contact force can only exist due to the actual touching of the two interacting objects. Contact force are only exist due to the actual touching of the two interacting objects. It means that we will feel only the contact forces. When we sit on the chair, we will feel some force due to the chair. When you put your hand on a table, then also you will feel some force. Okay, it means that the contact forces are the forces that will exist, that will be actually felt by the bodies or felt by human beings. Therefore, the forces that are arising because of the touching of one body with the other body can really exist there, and they will give the feeling of the force. Therefore, contact forces will give the feeling of the force. Whereas the force of gravity acting upon your body is not a contact force. It is often categorized as an action at a distance force, because the force of gravity is the result of your center of the mass and the Earth's center of mass exerting a mutual pull on each other. It means that the gravitational force is nothing but the force of mutual pull between the center of the human being are center of the body to the center of the earth. It means that the center of the body and the center of the earth, they are not in contact. Even though if you are in air also, if you are not in contact with the earth also, you can feel this gravitational field. It means that the gravitational pull, in gravitational force, gravitational force or pull, the two bodies are not in contact. This mutual force of pull will act, with the bodies at a distance. That's why they are not contact forces. This force would exist, even if you were not in contact with the earth also. Just now I said that if you are not in contact with the earth also, you can feel this force. If you are flying in the flight, then also you are having the gravitational pull, where you are not in direct contact with the earth. The force of gravity does not require that the two interacting objects make physical contact. It means that the force of gravity does not require the actual physical contact between the two bodies. Without physical contact, there are the gravitational forces. But the thing is, since the force of gravity is not contact force, you cannot felt it. You cannot felt the gravitational force. You are sitting, you are having so many mechanical positions. You will sit, you will stand, you will walk, you will crawl, whatever it might be. In all the cases, so you will be acted by the gravitational force, or the gravitational force is one of the most important force that is responsible for all your mechanical actions. But it is not felt. You won't feel the gravitational force. Whereas when you sat on a chair, when you sat on a stool, when you put your hand on wall, when you put your hand on a table, you will feel some force. Certainly you will feel some contact force. In the other way also I can explain. You can hold the wall, or you can put the hand stick, you will be able to walk. There you will feel some contact force. You will feel the real force, the feeling of the real force. Therefore, since the gravity force is not a contact force, you cannot feel it. The force of gravity can never be felt. Therefore, force of gravity can never be felt. It means that it is not a contact force. It means that all non-contact forces are not giving any feeling of force. Only the contact forces will give the feeling of the force. This is the final conclusion. Therefore, you can never feel the force of gravity pulling upon your body in the same way, that you would feel, you will feel a contact force. It means that, when once you sat on a chair, you will feel some force, whereas this kind of feeling doesn't arise because of the gravitational force which is continuously acting on your body. Therefore, in case of sitting in a chair, you can feel the chair force, and it is this force that provides you with a sensation of weight. Therefore, when once if you sat on a chair, when once if you stand on the earth, when once if you are walking, in all these cases, you are having contact forces. Therefore, only in the contact forces, you feel you will have the sensation of weight. You feel that you have the weight. That means that you can experience the sensation of the weight. Experience the sensation of the weight. While you are walking on sand, while you are walking on water, while you are walking on the normal road, while you are sitting, in all these cases, you are having contact forces, and you will certainly experience the sensation of the weight. Therefore, the contact forces, because of the contact forces, we will feel weight. Without contact forces, that is the gravitational force and such as some other forces which are not having any nature of contact, they won't give the sensation of or they won't give the feeling of the weight. Since the upward normal force would equal to the downward force of gravity at rest, the strength of this normal force gives the measure of amount of gravitational pull. When once if you are sitting on this one, the upward normal force, okay, is equal to the downward gravitational force when you are at rest or when you are walking. And this strength of normal force gives the measurement of the amount of the gravitational force. Therefore, you will feel, what is this one, the weight, the feeling of the weight. Whereas, if there is no normal force, if you are experiencing only the gravitational force, okay, then you won't get the feeling of the weight. I hope you will understand. Okay, if you are acted by only the gravitational force, in such case, okay, you won't feel, what is this one, the weight, because okay, it is not balanced by any other contact force. If any other contact force balances your weight, then only you will feel weight, the feeling of the weight, okay, or the sensation of the weight. Therefore, if there is no upward normal force acting upon the body, you would not have any sensation of weight. Without contact force, that is the normal force, there is no meaning of the feeling of force of gravity and no feeling of weight. Therefore, weightlessness is simply the sensation experienced by an individual when there is no external objects touching one's body and exerting push or pull upon it. It means that if your body is not having any physical contact with any other bodies, okay, which will exert either push or pull, okay, then in that case you won't feel any weight. If your body is having any physical contact with the other bodies, and if those bodies certainly exert some push or pull, in that case only you will feel the weight. Therefore, weightlessness sensation arises when all contact forces are removed. Therefore, weightlessness, if all the contact forces are removed, or if all the contact forces are not there, in that case, certainly we will feel the sensation of weightlessness. These sensations are common in the state of rupa. The sensation of weightlessness is common in the state of rupa, and weightlessness is only a sensation. It is not a real, and no individual has loss of weight. This feeling is due to the absence of contact force. Okay? It means that weightlessness is only the sensation. It is not a real thing. This sensation of weightlessness arises because of the lack of the contact forces. Lack of contact forces are very common in case of the body when once it is freely falling. This is about the actual reason for the weightlessness. Right. Weightlessness in the orbit, that is weightlessness of the astronauts. Okay, why the astronauts feel continuous weightlessness? Right. Yet the orbiting astronauts are weightless for the same reason that there is no external contact force pushing or pulling upon their body. Astronauts means these are the persons which will present in a satellite which rotates round the earth at a certain height. Every satellite that is rotating round the earth in a particular orbit is said to be a body of free fall. Said to be a body of free fall. It is in the state of free fall. It is in the state of free fall. Therefore, in the state of free fall, it is experienced by only the gravitational force, no contact force. The force of gravity is the only force acting on the body. The astronauts are in free fall. They are in the state of free fall. The astronauts and their surroundings are falling towards the earth under the sole influence of gravity. The spaceship or the satellite which is rotating round the earth in a particular orbit is said to be in the state of free fall with the sole influence or the whole influence of the gravity. The astronauts and their surroundings, the space station which is with its contact are falling towards the earth without colliding it. It means that when once it is in the state of free fall, generally you have to feel that it means that it is falling down and it will collide there. No, it is not falling down. It is in the state of free fall. Okay, no doubt. But the tangential velocity of the body, the tangential velocity that is acting on the satellite, okay, makes the satellite to remain in the object, to remain the satellite in the orbital motion, while the force of gravity pulls down them. It means that in case of satellite, when once it is launched in a particular orbit with some velocity, the satellite and of course the contents, that is the human being and the other, okay, the things that are there in the satellite, okay, are acted by some tangential velocity. This tangential velocity makes the satellite, okay, rotate round the earth. It means that it makes the satellite in an orbital motion, but the satellite is in the state of free fall. Therefore, only the gravitational force is acting on that one. Therefore, there is no contact force. Therefore, the human being that are present in the satellite are in the state of floating. It means that no contact forces are there. Therefore, even though they are rotating around the earth due to the tangential velocity, they are in the state of free fall. So, no contact forces, no feeling of weight. This is the state of weightlessness of the astronauts. Therefore, the astronauts will feel the state of weightlessness. Okay? The simple reason is, the astronauts are the spaceship along with the spaceship. They are in the state of free fall. Only gravitational force is acting. But the tangential force acts on this one, make it to orbit around the Earth. Okay, but it is in the state of free fall. Only gravitational force is acting. No contact forces are there. Therefore, the human that are present in the satellite will float. No contact forces, no feeling of weight. Therefore, this is nothing but the weightlessness. This is about the state of weightlessness as far as the astronauts is concerned. And of course, the feeling of decrease of weight. Okay, the feeling of decrease of weight, not weightlessness. The feeling of small decrease of weight will be also experienced, as I said previously, that is in the giant wheel while it is moving down, and the elevator moves down. Elevator, when once it starts for a fraction of a second, okay, for a fraction of a second, it starts down. It starts to move down in a fraction of a second. You will feel some loss of weight, and of course the aircraft moves down. When the aircraft, in order to land. Okay, in order to land, if the aircraft moves down from higher altitudes to lower altitudes, then also you feel certain loss of weight. Okay, of course, these examples are given to you for the feeling of the loss of slight loss of weight, you, in order to experience yourself, to have a vision on the weightlessness. To have a experience on the, okay, what is the true weightlessness that will take place. Okay, these are the common examples in order given to you to have your own experience, so that in all these three cases you feel slight loss of weight. Okay, right. This is about the weightlessness. And okay, let us move to the another topic, that is the second topic. What is that one? That is the physiological effects of astronauts. Physiological effects of astronauts. Right. Physiological effects of astronauts? Very significant topic that we have to learn, because so many interesting things, so many new things we will see as far as the astronauts are concerned. Astronauts means the persons which are rotating round the earth in a particular orbit along with their satellite, along with their spaceship. Physiological effect means these astronauts will be affected by the weightlessness, and will be affected by the radiation and etc. And because of all these things, human body will be affected. The organs of the human body will be affected. The organs of the human body will be disturbed. The functioning of the human organs of the human bodies will be disturbed because of the function, disturbance of the functioning of the organs of the human body, they will be in a state of some inconvenience. Okay, very inconvenience. Okay, all these inconvenience, okay, comes under the category of the physiological effects of the astronauts. It means that this topic will discuss how the human organs are affected by their space mission, by their space expedition. Okay, how the astronauts will be affected, the organs of their human body will be affected, how the functioning of the organs will be affected, and what are the crises or critical things that they will experience as far as their course of space motion, right? Many of the environmental conditions experienced by humans during the space travel are very different from those with their normal life. The environmental conditions of the human being in their normal life is very common one, very livable environmental conditions they will experience, whereas the environmental conditions experienced by the human during their space travel is very different from their normal life. When once the environmental conditions are very different their normal life, then what will happen? The total normal life, the normal activity of their organs will change. Entering into environment of space can have negative effects on the human body. Space expedition is it will give negative effects on human body. Significant adverse effects of long-term weightlessness includes muscle atrophy and deterioration of skeleton will take place. Astronauts, during their course of motion, they will remain in the space for a length of a few days or few weeks or few months. During this time, because of all this time, they will be under the feeling of weightlessness. This weightlessness leads to the muscle atrophy, degeneration, and deterioration of skeleton. It means that the total muscle system and skeleton system will be disturbed. Muscle system and skeleton system actually together will use the structure of the human being. It is the base for the functioning of different organs of the human being. When once these two are disturbed, then certainly a kind of difficulty will be arise for the astronauts. Other significant effects includes slowing of cardiovascular system functioning. What are the other influences? Slowing of cardiovascular system functioning. It means that the heartbeat will decrease production of red blood cells. Red blood cells will be decreased. Balance disorders will come. Balance disorder means the balance of the human skeleton and the human body while sitting, while walking, while running, and while different activities. So there is some balancing condition. This balancing condition will be disturbed. Eyesight disorders will arise, and a change in the immune system also. Immune system changes also arises. It means that all these things gives the signals that it is somewhat dangerous as far as the space persons are concerned or the astronauts are concerned. And also, in addition to these symptoms, there are fluid redistribution. This fluid redistribution, this causes the moon phase appearance in the picture of the astronauts experiencing weightlessness. fluid redistribution means the fluids from the head, from the upper part will be pulled down. That will have, what will happen, the total body of the human being will be diminished. This is what is known as the moon phase effect of the astronauts. It is because of the fluid redistribution, and this fluid redistribution is due to the weightlessness state. Loss of body mass will decreases. Nozzle conjunction, it means that the, fast respiration will take place, sleep disturbance arises, and the excess of flatulence will be taking place. Excess of, flatulence means the gas release will be taking place. Okay, these are all very bad, very serious, effects that will arise as far as the astronauts is concerned. But the technology offered by the spaceship or spacesuits can be protect the astronauts from the most difficult conditions. All these difficult conditions are reduced to a maximum extent by means of technology offered in the spaceships and the provision of space suits. They will wear the space suits and the technology in the spaceship reduces all these effects to a great extent. That's why they are not greatly affected. The immediate need of breathing air and drinking water are addressed by the life supporting systems. Each and every astronaut will be provided by life supporting system, his own life supporting system. His own life supporting system consists of breathing, consists of the system that will provide the air for the necessary breathing and water for the necessary amount of drinking. A group of other life supporting system equipment that supplies the air, water and food that a human need to live in outer space. The other supporting system also gives the air, water and food that human needs to live in the space. It must also maintain temperature and pressure within the limits of acceptable body waste products. Within the limits of body waste products will arise. Depends upon the limits of the body waste products, so the system inside the satellite will provide some supporting system which provides the temperature, the necessary temperature and necessary pressure also. And also again shielding against harmful external influences such as radiation and micrometeorites is also necessary. They are also provided some fields, shieldings. They are also protected by means of shields from the harmful external influences, such as the radiations and other things. These are all provided. Spaceship structure and of course the shielding, all these things will reduce all these effects for a great extent. But that is there, no doubt. Slight effects will still remain as far as astronauts are concerned. We will see what are the actual things that are fine and what are the actual disasters that will take place one by one. It is difficult to minimize certain risks such as weight loss. Weight loss cannot be minimized because weight loss is always there, as far as the astronauts is concerned, while they are in the space expedition. It is also defined as microgravity atmosphere. Living in this type of environment affects the body in three important ways. This weightlessness, that is what is known as the microgravity, will be provide an environment on the body of the human being in three different ways. One is the loss of proprioception, that is the change in body position and moments. Proprioception means change of body position and change of position moment. Next one, change in fluid distribution. Fluid distribution, fluid inside our human body, which will be actually what this one sticks to the muscles and the skeleton, okay, it will reduce the growth. And a degeneration of musculoskeleton system, it means that the musculoskeleton system means the coordination between the muscles and the skeleton will be degenerated. Okay, this is inevitable because of what this one, weightlessness. On November 2nd, 2017, scientists reported significant changes in the position and the structure of the brain in astronauts based on MRI studies. Okay, MRI studies of the astronauts reveals that position and the structure of the brain change. This was totally, of course, reported, okay, in 2017, November 2nd. Astronauts who have made more space missions are suffered with more brain changes. It means that if an astronaut, okay, makes more space missions, then, okay, he will be affected more, or his brain changes are, okay, will be affected more. In October 2019, NASA funded researchers discovered that long journeys into the outer space, including the journey to Mars, could significantly damage the astronauts' gastrointestinal tissues. What is this one? This is also one of the very important findings that was made by NASA funded researchers, and NASA funded researchers reveals that a great damage of astronauts' gastrointestinal tissues will take place when the astronauts go for long journeys into outer space, Such trips can significantly damage astronauts' brain and cause their premature aging. Such trips also damages the brain and also causes premature aging. It means that their appearance, or the body will get to premature aging effect, right? In March 2019, NASA reported that latent viruses in human body could be activated during the space mission. Another very important finding is during the space expedition, latent viruses that are there in the human being will be activated. This could add even more danger to the astronauts on deep space mission into the future. Because of the activation of the latent virus in the human body in a particular space mission, In the next space mission, he will be certainly affected and stepped into dangerous conditions because of the activation of the virus. Right. During takeoff and re-entry by space travelers, during the process of re-entry into the atmosphere, they can experience several times of normal gravity. It means that several times of normal gravity will take place. An untrained person can usually withstand about 3G. An untrained person can withstand 3G, three times of the gravitation acceleration, G value. But as far as the astronauts is concerned, they are subjected to 4 to 6 G. At higher vertical G forces, gravitational forces causes blood flow away from the brain and the eyes. It means that when human body is subjected to the 4G or say 6G, 4 to 6G, while he is coming back or while he is going up, that is take off and re-entry, he will be experienced by great gravitational force in the vertical direction, and the blood flow will take place away from the brain and the eyes. Because of the flow of blood away from the brain and eyes, first the person experiences temporary loss of vision, and then at higher G forces, loss of consciousness will take place also. G force training, gravitational force training and G shoot, which constricts the body to keep more blood in the head can mitigate the effects. It means that the G suit and G force training that is provided to the astronauts will keep their blood around the head, and it will try to limit the effects, or it will try to reduce the this great effects. Most spacecraft are designed to keep G force within the comfortable limits. Actually, these spacecrafts are also designed to provide some within the G limits also. The environment of the space is lethal without appropriate protection. Appropriate protection will be there. The great threat in the vacuum of the space arises from the lack of oxygen and pressure. Actually, there is a lack of oxygen and lack of pressure will be there, and this is also one of the great threat. And also the temperature and radiation is also poses some risk. Okay, because at higher altitudes, more temperature and more radiation will be also there. Space motion sickness is caused by conflicting information that your brain receives from your eyes and your inner ear. There is one sickness that is what is known as the space motion sickness. What is space motion sickness? Space motion sickness is nothing but different types of information that comes to your brain from your eyes and your inner ear. It means that the information sent by your eyes and your inner ear are different. These different informations will received by the brain. Therefore, it will confuse us. It is a kind of confliction. This confliction leads to a kind of sickness that is what is known as the space motion sickness. Human organs are attached mainly at the top of the top. So in microgravity, they tend to shift around, and that can make us nauseous. Most of the human organs are there. At the upper part of the human being, and because of the microgravity, they will shift, and because of this shiftness, the body will diminishes, the structure of the body will diminishes. Also, you do not feel thirsty and decrease of your fluid intake. Actually, astronauts doesn't feel thirsty because the decrease of intake, therefore what will happen, they doesn't need to more fluid intake. You become dehydrated. The result is 20% of loss of blood volume. Astronauts, as they are not feel thirsty, as they are not taking much liquids, what will happen, their blood volume will be reduced by 22%. Because of the excessive elimination of the fluids by the kidneys. Kidneys are eliminating the fluids, but you are not taking the fluid. The astronaut is not taking the fluid. Therefore, there is also decrease of formation of red blood cells. That's why what will happen? Formation of red blood cells will be decreases. I hope you will understand. Kidneys are doing their own business. They are eliminating this one, but you are not taking the intake fluids are very less. Blood volume decreases. Therefore, what will happen? Red blood cells count will be decreases. The change in blood volume affects your heart. Very, very important thing. Just now we said that blood volume will be changed by 22%. It will affect your heart. How will it will affect your heart? This is the way. That is, if you have less blood in your heart, your heart does not need to pump as hard. It means that if a person is having less blood, his heart does not work normally. It need not put more effort. It will simply put less effort because it no longer has to work. Less blood is there. It has to work lessly. It has to work less. Therefore, it may not effort more. Therefore, it may not work hard. And what will happen? Your heart will shrink in size. When once the heart function is not normally there, heart function reduces. Then the size of the heart will shrink. Okay, the size will reduces. That is one of the very important effect. Upon returning to the earth, gravity will pull these fluids back down to your legs and away from your head, causing you feel pain when you are stand up. Okay, upon returning to the earth, what will happen? Gravity will pull these fluids back. They will pull it back down, okay, legs and other parts also. Because of this change, okay, we are not in a position to stand properly. Prolonged space radiation exposure can have wider range effects on the body. Radiation can damage to the DNA. The danger of damage to the DNA is one of the most important things. This is because of the exposure to the outer space radiation. Space travelers sleep poorly in the space. Their average sleep is 2 hours, less than 2 hours, because why it is so? Okay, in low Earth orbit, so sun rises and sets in 90 minutes. In every 90 minutes, so sun rises and sun sets as far as the low Earth orbit is concerned. Therefore, their average sleep is only 2 hours. Therefore, they sleeplessness. The sleeplessness thing will be also accustomed with this one. What happens when the astronauts return to the Earth is, when the astronauts return to Earth, what will be happening is, heart is smaller and it is weaker. The vestibular or balancing system will be affected. System has become used to new set of signals. Our system will get the new set of system because it comes again. Body fluids are diminished. Muscles have atrophied and bones have weakened. Muscles will be atrophied. It means that muscles will be diminished and also the bones are also weakened. That's why when once the astronauts return to the Earth, all these effects will be arises. Therefore, what will happen? When astronauts return to the Earth, they are not allowed to move into the society. They will be examined. They will be kept in a special rooms, special treatment rooms, special observation rooms. In the observation rooms or in the observation enclosures, they will provide all the things that they have need in order to retrieve or redact their all the things that are they experience. It means that when once they are treated, or when once they are observed, or when once they are properly treated in the special enclosures, for some time all these effects will be minimized to a great extent. It means that their heart function, vestibular system, balancing system, this is the power of receiving the signals, and all such other things will be minimized slowly for a few days. And after few days, after they are recovered and after they are retrieved or retained their original original health conditions, that is the original working conditions of their organs, then only they are allowed to move into the society. That's why all these steps will be taking place, and whatever it might be, astronauts has to experience all these adverse effects, very bad adverse effects, and these bad adverse effects are minimized by means of the suitable design of the spacecraft, minimized by means of providing space suit, and minimized by means of some life supporting systems, and the other which are unable to minimize, can remain, and they are addressed and minimized after they return back to the Earth by means of the supporting systems and the supporting atmosphere for a few days. In that way, the effects of the astronauts will be addressed after they return back. This is about the physiological effects of the astronauts, and we discussed two important topics. One is the weightlessness and the physiological effects of the astronauts, which are very interesting, or which are very general things that we should know, okay, what is actually the meaning of the weightlessness, the cause of the weightlessness, and what is the physiological, the actual physiological effects of the asanas, how serious they are, how they are addressed, okay, and all these things are very interesting, right? See you in the next class.